Well, this is a bit fancy.
I'm somewhere a bit different today. My uni has a recording studio that they've recently set up that's free for students to use, and so I thought I'd come in and try it out. It's probably a bit too serious for the kind of casual video I filmed today, but I think it might be good in the future filming sort of educational or more scientific videos. So let me know if you have any suggestions for the things I could film in here.
One thing I didn't expect to learn when I went to uni was computer science. At that time, I was only interested in theoretical physics and astronomy. But in my first year, I was enrolled in a computer science course because it was recommended for the astronomy major. I sort of showed up having no idea what to expect. I kind of thought we'd be learning about hardware and what a RAM is, how things actually work. But I was sort of surprised with what we actually did learn, which was what are variables and types and how do you make functions and how do you tell a computer how to do something for you. I kind of had a love-hate relationship with this course. I liked it because, unlike all the other courses, I was really learning something new. With especially the first year physics courses, it almost felt like we were rehashing basic ideas that we learned in physics at school. So we were doing mechanics or electricity and magnetism, or a little bit of quantum. And whilst they were harder than school, it was sort of still the same ideas. This computer science though that I was introduced to, I'd really never learnt it before. But actually there were also reasons I didn't enjoy this course. In comparison to my other courses, it was the only one where I really felt like I was behind all of my peers. Instead of aiming for the top of the class like I was trying to do in my other courses, I felt like I was struggling to keep up, and I always had to ask for help, and I sort of felt a bit uncomfortable with that at first. When some of my friends were discussing coding projects they'd done previously in various languages, I was still thinking, oh, can you tell me again what is a function? But I got over that, sort of got over myself, and I did enjoy the course so much that eventually I took some more computer science courses and learned things like algorithms or data structures and how to write more effective code. And I'm really glad I took some of those further courses. So the first research project I ended up doing in my degree, I was working at an observatory in Sydney, and I was essentially processing images of galaxies to design a CubeSat satellite and also a telescope. I found out that there wasn't really much astronomy knowledge needed to do this research project. It was kind of an exercise in coding. My supervisor for this project actually had done his degree in computer science and then specialized in astronomy later on. And I think that's kind of a good way to do it, actually. I think someone in astronomy with no computer science knowledge would actually really struggle because you'd have to teach yourself coding as you go. And whilst you can probably do that, it might not be as efficient as if you knew some more of that background behind it. As for physics, it really depends on the kinds of things you want to specialize in. Theoretical projects that involve a lot of modeling or coding simulations, I think coding is of course going to be a very important skill there. And also for experimental work, if you're often handling really large data sets, you have to know how to manipulate and keep track of that data, often through coding. It is possible to find projects within physics that don't use a lot of coding if you really want to stay away from it. And personally, my project now doesn't actually use much of that, but it is a really useful skill to have, especially if you want to automate tasks on a computer and make things easier for yourself. I also think that a knowledge of coding or computer science is going to help you not just in research and with research projects, but going out into industry and your employability later on. A lot of physicists end up working and storing and manipulating data in roles such as a software engineer working for big companies. So I think no matter what you want to do, it would be a really good skill to supplement all of your physics or your maths or your astronomy coursework. The courses I did were taught in the language Python, and that's what I've used for all the research projects I've done as well. But there are lots of other languages that are applicable to science, and you might also encounter some other sort of coding software along the way. For example, R for statistics, MATLAB for managing data and doing things with linear algebra and matrices, and also Mathematica, which is really good for solving equations. You'll probably encounter some of these throughout your coursework, and they're for solving the more everyday problems. Learning how to use these tools is more about learning syntax, and you can sort of get away with not knowing some of the more theoretical computer science aspects, but it certainly doesn't hurt. If you're not yet at uni, I really recommend you try and learn some basic coding skills. There's lots of really awesome programs that run now, whether it's in schools or outside of schools, where you can learn the basics of programming so that maybe when you get to uni, you don't feel as bewildered as I first did. I think it's a skill you can pick up quite early on as well. It doesn't require a lot of background knowledge to get started. You don't need to have really good math skills or anything. You can sort of learn the language from quite a young age, I think. And if you are already at uni, maybe majoring in physics, I'd say to try and take as many computer science courses as you can alongside your studies. I think they'll really help you, especially if you don't already have sort of a self-taught prior knowledge in the field. Keep an open mind as well. If you take maybe a couple of extra computer science courses along the way, you might find you enjoy it more than what you initially intended to major in, and that might be your new thing.